Hey, what's up everybody? Frank Valkyria, welcome to the channel. Today we're doing a reaction suggestion by Sandra, and I just did another video talking what happened a day ago or today, or like a couple of days ago, I don't know, I already forgot, I didn't check the date, in Brazil regarding the Corfu Carfu accident to Beto. And Sandra suggested to react to this song from Elsa Soares. So let's go together. Let's check it out. Boom. Wow, guys, let me know if I understand this correctly. She's singing a carne más barata do mercado, a carne negra. A carne más barata do mercado, a carne negra. The cheapest meat on the market is the black meat. That's heavy, man. Beautiful voice. The growl. Beautiful voice when she goes like and she keeps the beautiful sustain. What a powerful voice. I mean, in conjunction with what I just said and regarding the article, rest in peace Beto, I mean, it's absolutely powerful, this simple phrase, you know, immediately gives you an entire image, something that it's been traded, and then has all the roots historically to the trading of black slaves from the African continent to the Americas. Powerful stuff. And again, I'm so fed up with all kinds of racism from whatever side, from whatever place on the globe, you know, like it just doesn't compute in my head that we are not aware of science, we are not aware of the basic truth that we are just Homo sapiens sapiens. Nice, funky, man. Ooh. Beautiful, beautiful. Also with this 70s, you know, organ, Moog, probably. Very nice. Another thing, I'm like, also, for me, like, I understand that, when you talk about black community, people refer among themselves also as black people and so on and so forth. But there is also a reason for that. The dramatic history, especially in the US, the lack of having a clear connection with your past because you were raped of it. You were like just abused and taken from your original place somewhere else by force, your ancestor, all that kind of stuff is just absurd. It's a tragic history of our humanity, of our past. And going back to I just wish we were to the place where we wouldn't have to call each other colors. You know, like, there is not such a thing as calling people of colors, you know, in general, like anybody. Because as a painter myself, you know, probably I've said this before, it's so amusing that we are so wrong about everything, also the basic stuff, you know. As a painter, you learn to try to look at things and understand what color they are, you know, like in order to try to mimic it on the canvas and how you mix it. And when you look at people's skin, you know, like you look at a white person, and then you realize there is nothing white about a skin of a person. You know what I mean? It's a combination of pinkish and undertones of blue and greens and all kinds of sear and burned and all those combination which come up with you know, with this color. The same thing for a darker tone of skin. You realize that there is nothing black in the skin of a black person. even the darkest skin, it's a combination of burnt skin with a combination of yellow, combination of red, and combination, you know, like of those things in a certain way that actually more close to each other, you know, like a person so-called white and a person so-called black, you know, they're so more close to each other in terms of gradients of shades of colors than, you know, between white and black. So it's just absurd already that. And also another reason is because we are just human beings. We are just Homo sapiens sapiens. We have the same DNA. We come from the same thing. We share DNA with freaking everything on this planet in a certain percentage, you know? There is probably, I wouldn't be surprised if we share like 50% DNA with a spider or with a frog or all kinds of other mammals, or even more probably with mammals. So that teaches us, like I said in the other video, that we are just creature. We are life. We are life from, comes from cells, and DNA packed with information takes different iterations here and there, adapting to the environment. And we human beings, you know, just for those little superficial features which they changed according to different areas where we have adapted, and we sort of get scared of each other for that. I mean, can we just look beyond it and just stop calling each other colors? You know, we are just human beings. We have to stop calling each other colors. It's I understand it's like a way of course, like somebody has a darker skin, somebody has a lighter skin. But if we start to categorize, you know, like I know it's a sort of an attempt, scientific attempt, but actually I remember looking up who was the guy that invented this category, you know, of putting people in categories of Caucasian and Asian and African and so on and so forth. I think, if I'm not mistaken, was a German dude. I mean, this stuff is just up in the air, you know what I mean? Like science, modern science has debunked those things a long time ago, yet we still sort of keep repeating those things, making us believe that we are different. You know, we're Homo sapiens sapiens. We are one thing. One thing. I really enjoy this, you know, like very also old-fashioned 80s rap, you know, with the scratching of the vinyl effect type of thing, you know, and also the 70s Moog coming in, her voice, so R&B with that growl that she does and that power. I really like the flair. Obviously, this song, it's not from yesterday, but also doesn't look like this is the 80s. This is looks like it could be 2000, mid-2000, or late 90s, from the format of the video, late 90s, early 2000. So nice, the song keeps repeating a little bit, like, you know, there is this main phrase, and like I said, reminds me also of that there is a, to me also maybe a connection with Team Maya, you know, the songs of Team Maya that I reviewed, reacted to. There are also some which they present this type of dynamic, you know, where you keep repeating a phrase, you know, throughout the song, which is the main thing that drags the song forward, in between spaces of little instrumental part. And again, like I said also probably before, this type of songs are very interesting to listen to it from a musical standpoint live, because you get much more space that perhaps the singer with those beautiful voices, you know, they're just gonna go maybe more freely doing every coming back in the chorus, maybe with a different, you know, variation. And also instrumentally, perhaps, you know? You could go, like, through, like, little solos. And also, those freaking people are all fit! Very fit! Hello, baby. Wow, guys, this was a very nice song, actually, also with a super powerful message. And I apologize for the little rant, but you know, sometimes I'm really fed up with this, you know, like I have the trust that the majority of human beings, you know, are good, we mean good, so I have that trust. But unfortunately, that doesn't take many to spoil everything for the rest. So racism exists, but it can also be extinguished very quickly, because like I said in the other video, it's a combination of false beliefs, doctrines passed down, historical stuff that we pass down people, and people embrace and create those strange thoughts, strange ideals, you know, which they have no place in 2020. They have absolutely no place. We are human beings. We are just common. We are mammals. We have in common with every other mammals. You have in common with the freaking blue whale. You know, that's freaking amazing. You have in common with the dolphin or with the lion. You know, so we are life. So that again should be enough. Just open up your head, your brain, look around you, embrace this planet, and you realize we are one thing, really. The closed-mindedness, it's what creates those absurdity. Like I said, we got to get rid of it. We got to get rid of those hill ideas, and we just open up to knowledge, wisdom, and science. And the next generation will not even be aware of all this shit that we had to go through, and we do to each other, unfortunately. So, at the end of the day, again, always spread love. I'll see you later. You take care.